Living the good life full of goodbyes. My eyes are on the gray sky, saying I don't want to come home tonight. Yeah, and I'm high up off work. I don't even remember, but my friend passed out in the override. Oh, I'm from the city of the 915.
Hi, everyone. Michelle Noren here, semi-professional roller derby player and founder of Colchester is Kind. I am so excited for this video today because you're going to hear about a topic that is just near and dear to my heart, Mental Health Awareness Month. There are three people in this video each have special important messages to share with you. So let's start things off with someone you might recognize. Here's Danielle from Love is Blind Season 2.
Hello, Colchester, Connecticut students. I am Danielle Ruhl, and for those who don't know me, I am from the Season 2 of Love is Blind. And I am really excited to be a part of Mental Health Awareness Month with you guys. For those who don't know me, mental health and mental health awareness is extremely important to me. And the more you talk about it, the more we'll be able to break the stigma. And that's why I love that we have a whole month that is dedicated to talking about these topics. There are so many reasons why mental health is important, why ending the stigma is important, and why it is okay to not be okay and to ask for help. So just to begin, I wanted to start with a little bit of my background about myself and why mental health education is so important to me. So I started realizing that I, you know, was starting to have different feelings when I was only 8 years old. However, at the time, I didn't even know that the words depression or anxiety existed. And I really wish I would have been more educated at the time. So one, I would have been able to communicate with others how I was feeling. And in addition to that, get the support that I needed. Because when I did end up communicating my feelings, I found that there were so many other people who felt similar to me. And that is why it's important to know it's okay to not be okay. The more you realize this, the more you'll be able to accept your feelings, find coping mechanisms, and connect with so many other people that relate to you. And it may be scary, and it is, you know, scary to talk about how you're feeling. But once you realize how many other people feel the same way you do, you could actually start to feel better. I know when I started opening up, I found a wide community of people who related to me, and even if they didn't, wanted to support me, and I did start to feel better. Additionally, mental health awareness and education is important so that friends, families, teachers, and communities can all learn to best support those who are struggling, as well as make sure they're providing an open door and open environment to these conversations, because they're hard, they're tough, but they're so beneficial. And if you put it into perspective, when you think about physical health, if you were to break a leg, more times than not, you'll know how to get care for that broken leg. You will tell people that you have a broken leg, and you will be able to go and contact the medical service needed to take the next steps to get help. However, there's not as much education and awareness of how to address mental health. Because it isn't as commonly talked about in our communities. And a lot of that is because of the stigma. So that's why we need to embrace open communication of mental health challenges and be able to provide directions to help others. There's no shame in asking for help, and there are tools and treatments to respond and treat and manage mental health issues. I have taken so many steps in order to get to where I am now. It's a journey, but again, it all starts with being open and communicating with those that are around you, and also understanding, again, that it's okay to not be okay and there's nothing wrong with you. 1 in 4 people struggle with mental health, and that's the 1 in 4 who acknowledge it and open up about it. So again, you're not alone. It's okay to ask for help. It's important to ask for help. And if you do, you should be proud of yourself. Be proud of yourself if you recognize that you may need to ask for help. It takes self-awareness and courage, and this conversation is so important, but you doing it and you having this conversation and you listening to this right now does help end the stigma. And again, I hid my feelings for so long, and I wish so badly that I would have been confident or had the resources or the education when I was younger to recognize how I was feeling, to find ways to find support for myself and also find ways to support others who needed it. So together, I'm hoping that like all of us around the world and together we can build a non-judgmental community to help break the stigma and help others know that they are not alone. I'm proud of all you guys for listening to me and having these conversations, and I'm so happy to be a part of your guys' journey and a part of your guys' Mental Health Awareness Month. So thank you so much and sending love.
Thank you so much, Danielle, for that heartfelt message. Next up, we've got a message from Maurice Hurst Jr., football defensive tackle for the Cleveland Browns.
Hey guys, Maurice Hurst here, defensive tackle for the Cleveland Browns and former defensive tackle at the University of Michigan. I'm here to talk to you guys for Mental Health Awareness Month. I just want to stress the fact that everyone has mental health, just like everyone has physical health. And for our physical health, we do things like eat healthy foods, exercise, work out, and the same should go for your mental. And a lot of times, being a boy, a man, we go through phases where we feel like we have to be tough or be strong, but that's not the case. And a true sign of strength is being able to talk to those people that are important to you about what's going on in your head, what you're dealing with, what kind of anxiety you have or emotions that you're going through, and confiding in each other, whether that's another student, a teacher, a counselor, your parents, a friend. It doesn't matter who it is. You have to be able to have these conversations with these people, especially if they're important to you. And not only will it help with your mental health, but if you guys have ever noticed, whenever you talk to somebody about these type of issues or things that are going on in your life that are stressing you out, it brings you guys closer as a community. So never be afraid to talk to each other about what's going on. That will be a true sign of strength for you guys, and it will only help you further on in your life as you continue to get into, you know, middle school, high school, and get into college and become an adult. These are all important things, and it's very important to start working on it now. So for Mental Health Awareness Month, I just want each and every one of you guys to, you know, find a friend, find a counselor, find a parent, and tell them something that's on your mind that just isn't, you know, hey, how's your day going? It's good. Like, no, like, really dig deep into what you're dealing with and what's going on inside you. And that's all I got to say. Hope you guys have a great rest of your day. And thank you so much. Love.
I just love everything Maurice had to share, especially the part about boys not being afraid to reach out if you need help. All right, so lastly, last but not least, coming up in June is Pride Month. So we have an extra special message about mental health within the LGBTQIA+ community from Rock'em Sakura from the 12th season of RuPaul's Drag Race.
Hey everyone at Colchester, it's me, Rock'em Sakura, from the cast of season 12 of RuPaul's Drag Race, and I'm here today to talk to you guys about a very important issue that is very close to my heart. We're going to be talking about Mental Health Awareness Month right now in May. I thought that it would be important for me to speak because mental health and staying aware of your mental health status is such a very important thing to me, especially being a member of the LGBTQIA+ community. We are very susceptible, you know, to depression and like feelings of self-harm and stuff like that too. And I want to let you guys know that where you guys are right now, having thoughts about your mental health and how to take care of yourself and not knowing how to do it, it happens. I want you guys to know that there are resources around you. There are teachers, there are parents, there are adults, there are hotlines you can call for anyone that can help you with your mental health. And I know that sometimes it can be hard when you have a mental health problem or people don't validate the way that you feel up here. There are multiple venues for people so you can discuss how you feel with people that will listen to you. Not everyone's parents are going to listen to them about what they have to say here. I've had parents that have been like, oh, you're depressed? Well, why don't you just be happier? And for those of us who do struggle with mental health, it's not something like that. You can't just flip a switch and make yourself happier. If there's anything I can impart to you this month, is that your school, your teachers, everyone out there, they are resources for you to ask for help with your mental health. And I want you to make sure that you're taking care of yourself and that you're being kind to yourself this month. And that if you ever feel like you might not be the nicest to yourself, confide in a friend, confide in a family member, confide in a teacher. We are all here for you and we love you. It's almost Pride. It's almost Pride. And I would love, love for all of you guys to come into Pride being so happy and healthy and just taking care of yourselves, being kind to yourselves. I know this video has gone on long, but I really do care about this stuff and I really do care about you guys. So please take care of yourself. And please, if you ever need help, once again, reach out to people around you. And of course, your community group, Colchester is Kind, is always here to help you. I love you guys. Please take care of yourself and happy Pride when it comes to it. Bye, guys.
Mental health is so critically important. I hope you enjoyed these special messages today. And please know that if you need someone to talk to, you have teachers, guidance counselors, friends, and family who you can turn to. Happy Mental Health Awareness Month.